Hello and welcome. My name is Arturo Spraycasso, and if you're watching this video, it's because you're either like me, a spray painter, or you are, as I once was, curious about the art of spray painting. Now, before we get into that, let's tackle down the important issues. First of all, your health is very important to us, so you're going to want to make sure you always wear your mask, always. And when spray painting, you want to do it outside or in a very well ventilated area. Now that we got that out of the way, let's talk about the materials we're going to use in the art of spray painting. The basic materials is magazine sheets, different size of cups, lids, poster board, sea sponge, most importantly, a mask. I prefer you find a mask with filters. The Spraycasso tools, you can find how to make these on my website. Different size of straight edges. And of course, your favorite brand of spray paint. Right, everyone, so before we get started, I want to remind everyone about some of the essentials that you're going to want to look for when looking for stencils for planets. Now, planet making is the most basic style of spray painting art you can do because it doesn't require a whole lot and you can begin immediately. So what I want you to do is I want you to go through your house and find everyday items, you know, bowls. This is actually a little jello bowl. They're really cheap. You can buy these for, I think it was like 15 for about $5. So the beauty of these is the edge. This is something that you want to keep in mind when looking for stencils to use. So you want the edge to be sharp. No, not sharp as in it'll cut you. Sharp as in it's rather small. Notice. See how it goes? You don't want anything that goes in and bends inward or outward. Now you'll see that in plastic bowls, you know, cups. Try to avoid those. Stick with something that has a very small edge, rather sharp. Look at this. This is perfect for what we're needing. The edge doesn't bend inward. It's just right. All right, so I'm gonna use the caps of spray paints. You can use your own spray paints if you want. You put that down. The end is rather sharp as well. All right, so let's get started. Here I have different sizes of cups, lids, bowls. This is a microwave cover. Now, what I like about the microwave cover is that it has a little handle on top. See that? So you're able to place that down, pick it up. So you're gonna wanna do that with your caps as well. I know you've noticed on this last cap, I added a piece of tape, and it's, you know, just masking tape. It's really easy to remove or add. So what you're gonna wanna do once you get your tape, fold it, get a little handle going like that, and then just tape it to your bowl or cup or lid, something that'll allow you to pick it up. See that? All right, so what we're trying to prevent is if it doesn't have a lid, we don't want to accidentally move it, you know. We want to be able to just pick it up really quick. All right, guys, so if you guys are ready, what do you say we get started on our first spray painting? First, we're gonna concentrate on the colors that we're gonna use for our planets. So here I'm gonna begin with a very basic. I'm gonna use the biggest stencil that I have. I'm gonna place that down. I'm also gonna add maybe something like this and one right there. Now, as you've noticed, that bowl that I have right here doesn't have a little way to be picked up without. Look at that. Okay, perfect. So I just put some tape on that. You're gonna wanna be able to spread your planets a little bit. You know, get a feel for the dimension of how you want your planets to be spaced. In this case, I think something like, maybe like this. What do you guys think? What I like to do to save on spray paint, because there is a difference when you're spray painting home alone than when you're out performing in the streets. In the streets, you know, you've seen the street spray painters. They use a lot of spray paint, you know. These are techniques that I'll show you later on because they are a little bit different than when you're spray painting at home. Now, the difference is that that form of art is more concentrated for showmanship, to be able to attract people to you. Here, we're gonna concentrate on practicality. What I like to do just a little bit of spray around my stencils so that when I remove them, you automatically know where they're gonna go. You automatically know how much paint to use. I'll give you an example. We're gonna start off with my bigger planet here. Now, you're also gonna need, as we talked about, we're gonna need magazine sheets. So any kind of magazine will work. You just wanna grab it, tear off a piece. All right. I'm just gonna set that, I'm gonna fold it, I'm gonna set it right here. All right, so I want this planet to be rather colorful. I wanna show you guys some techniques that I use to do this. We're gonna start off with maybe a dark blue on top. All right, dark blue. And then maybe we can use, you know what? Some light blue. Now it's always useful, guys, to shake your cans before every use. You wanna shake them and pre-spray them before spraying directly onto your canvas. This ensures that you mix the chemicals, the drying agents and the gloss with the paint. All right, so we're just gonna do a little quick streak there. I'm also gonna do, you know what? We're gonna do some bright colors. So I have lime green. It's one of my favorite colors to use in my paintings. Okay, we're gonna use a little bit there. I'm gonna use some orange. I'm gonna use some yellow. And I think I'm gonna change it up a little bit. I'm gonna put some red here on the bottom. Yep. And you know what? I'm gonna add a little bit of black here. And maybe one streak going across. Why not? Let's experiment with it. All right, so what I'm gonna do, this is called the spray on spray technique. It's a technique that I use on a lot of my paintings, and this is what we use to manipulate some of these colors. So what I'm gonna do here, this is white. White and gloss black. You wanna use gloss colors, guys, at all times. Always wanna stick with gloss colors. They mix better. The matted ones tend to blend and mix together. So you'll get, you know, a muck of like a gray tone color. You wanna stick with the gloss colors. So gloss white and gloss black are neutral colors. We can use this on top of other colors and then put colors on top of that. In this case, we're not gonna do that. I'm gonna use the liquefy technique. This is a technique that I use to create the effect of water. Doesn't require much, just a magazine sheet. You wanna fold it in the shape of a U, just like that. See that? You don't wanna bend it, you wanna keep it nice and smooth. All right, here we go. Just gonna mix these colors together. Now notice how it does look like water, doesn't it? And you're able to create pretty realistic looking planets, textures, and yes, even water. Look at that. Very easy to do. You saw it, didn't take much than just a magazine sheet going back and forth a couple of times. Okay, so now I'm gonna concentrate on my other two planets. I also want them to be pretty bright, so you know what? I'm gonna use my lime green. I'm gonna make one of them lime green. Just gonna add a nice thick coat. I'm gonna put one of my neutral colors, gloss black. I'm just gonna do that on top of it. Now I'm gonna take my magazine sheet. There's different ways of creating texture. One of them, very simple, you just put your magazine sheet down and remove. Now what this is gonna do, it's gonna start removing some of the black from on top, giving you a nice little highlight of lime green underneath. Watch this. See that? Now, the more green you want to show up, the more you're gonna have to put and remove some of that black. So I'm just using a magazine sheet, placing it down. Look at that. I like that. There's nice color to it. You can move a little bit more if you'd like. Okay. Now let's do the same with this planet above. I think for that one, I'm going to use, oh, you know what? Let's use orange. I want the bright colors to be underneath. So I'm going to use a little bit of orange. Heck, you know what? Let's add some yellow too. Bright colors. Now I want these bright colors to really stand out. So we're going to be using our gloss black. Just like that. Quick spray on top. We're going to go ahead and use another magazine sheet. I'm just going to tear off about halfway. Put that down. Look at that. You don't see it? Well, let's try it again. Remove some of that black and it starts to really show up. And you see a bunch of nice little texture on there. Okay, great. So now we have our planets. Now we have to concentrate on depth. How do you do depth? Well, it's very simple. You use the light and dark technique. That's where you create shadows and lights to give the illusion that the planets are either closer to you or farther away from you. So let's begin with our main planet here, our big planet. Now, I'm just going to do this to kind of get an idea of how big my planet is. Okay, good. I'm going to add the shadow. How do you add the shadow? You do want some of that mist to land on your planet because notice how it's already giving it that 3D look. See how the colors come and then it gets into a nice little shadowing and then it goes into darkness. Well, that's what we want. Just going to add some color here. Now, again, you want your can to be a good foot away from your painting when creating the lighter shades of black. The closer you get, the darker it'll get. See that? So you want to try and avoid that. You want to keep your painting a good foot away. And you can experiment this by using various techniques. Let me show you. Up close. Nice big strong dot, right? Okay, I'm gonna separate my painting a good 6 inches. Still, but notice how much bigger it is. Once you do a foot, look at that. See that? It disperses a little bit more evenly and wider. So you wanna keep your painting, you know, kinda your can away from your painting a good foot away when you're doing this. Let me show you a technique to create a nebula. I think this technique is gonna be very helpful for you guys. You guys ever look into the Milky Way and you see kind of that ripple through space? Well, it's very easy to create. I'm gonna create it using green. I'm just gonna spray a little bit of green. See, green. All right, I'm gonna put that down. Put this down right about here. I'm gonna use a magazine sheet. You can use your magazine sheets to create texture as well. I'm just gonna tap into this. Just kind of create a little smudge here on the side of the painting. Look at that. Okay. Doesn't require a whole lot. Just a nice little smudge going through here. Okay. Now we're going to leave that there for a little bit. Then we're going to go over it and we're going to add some. This is just some quick texture. Then we're going to use the nebula technique on top of it to give it more depth and dimension to it. All right, so what I'm going to do now, we need to add some more shadows. Sorry. So now you have to determine where is your light source going to be coming from. In this case, I'm thinking this is a pretty good spot. Now notice what I'm doing with my fingers here. I like to symbolize where the light rays are going to be coming from. So by doing this, I know that the light is going to be hitting here, here, and here. So the shadows have to be on opposite ends, right? Right about here and right about there. So that's what I'm trying to do here. Keep my light source. A little bit of black here. Now you do want some of that black. I know. Now you have to practice. You don't want to do it too close, remember? All right. We use this one. I'm going to put this one right here. And you don't want to put a whole lot of pressure either. And I'm going to put this one right about there. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. Now, let's add a little more dark here. I want to give this planet a little more dimension, because this is the bigger planet. I mean, you're going to be able to see all the texture on it. All right. So I'm going to put my stencil down here as well. Now, remember, you don't have to put a whole lot of pressure down. You just have to place it and drop it. That's it. You don't want to smear it or move it over. Now, let's concentrate on this nebula here. I'm going to use some of my lime green. I told you I love this color. I'm just going to add a little bit of color around it. Now, I don't want to completely dissipate or not be able to see the texture that we added down. So I'm just going to back away. I'm a good foot away from my painting. Maybe a little bit of green down here. Okay. Now, we can add a little bit of our light blue or sky blue. I like to make my nebulas very colorful. You ever looked into space or seen those space pictures from NASA? You'll see a lot of bright colors. So I try and incorporate that into my paintings. All right. So now we have the texture. We have some color around it. Now it's time to add some of the space. All right. Now notice how what I'm doing. Quick bursts. If you do long bursts, you'll get a blob of paint. You don't want that. You want to be able to cover some of the color, but you don't want to make it really runny. Now, the planets, you always, always, guys, have to go all the way around to make sure you get a nice round planet. Sometimes one of the mistakes you see a lot of beginners do is when you start creating a planet and you don't go all the way around, your planet will look oval-like. You don't want to do that. So to prevent that, you want to make sure you go all the way around your planet. Okay, I'm just going to add some of that color here. We're going to do the same to our planet, our big planet. Now you want to make sure you go all the way around. I'm covering some of that excess color. We don't really need it. I'm just going to go all the way around. Now some of this area here, you don't want some of this white space to show. This is called a negative space. Negative space is just basically the color of your canvas. See, we're going to want to cover that up. We still have some negative color here. Okay. Now I'm going to leave this negative color because I want to create the effect of a light source. Remember, we're going to put our light source here and it's going to go outwards. So to do that, I'm going to begin by adding some red. Just like this. You want that red to really show. Now, as we get closer to the middle, we're going to line it up. So we're going to add some orange. Look at that. Just like that. That's right. Can you guess the last color I'm going to use? That's correct. We're going to use some yellow. Remember, you always want to shake, pre-spray, before spraying on your canvas. Now, I've already shaken and pre-sprayed all my cans that I have here, but you guys want to make sure you do that because I've gotten some emails where, well, you don't shake your can. No, I do. I do. I just sometimes I forget to show it. All right. So now we have these nice transitional colors. What is a transitional color? That's when it goes from red to orange to yellow. That's dark blue, light blue, and white. You know, it's, you want that transitional between the two. Now this is going to be our light source, so it was very important for me to create that there. I'm going to go ahead and add some more black on some of these negative spaces up here. And at the same time, it's going to blend in with some of the colors that I've placed down. And notice the quick bursts. You want to work with light layers. It just makes your painting be able to more maneuverable, easier to work with. All right. So now look at what we've created. We know we have our planets. We have a nice little nebula here. I'm going to show you guys how to create stars. Very easy to do. You're going to want your gloss white. Always go with glass or gloss colors. And I go like this. Now you want to aim your can parallel to your painting. You want to go 45 degree angles, and very gently you're just going to want to let your paint sputter. You guys see all those drops? Now this may take a little practice. See that? But you can see all the little stars, and if you get closer to it, you see a lot more going on here. Right, we're gonna add a few more. And look at that. How easy was that? Very easy. Now, here's the thing that I'm gonna show you guys, how to create a sun, a distant sun. Now there's various techniques of creating that. How is this? I'm gonna put my paint, my can right up to this. I'm gonna practice. Oh, that's too much. See? So I'm gonna back away a little bit. Yeah, that sounds about right. So I'm a good 4, 4.5 inches away from my poster. I'm gonna try and simulate that right about here. Look at that. So now you have your light source, you have your yellow, your orange, your red, and it disperses into the background, into the space. All right, I'm also gonna show you how to create a nice little bright star. What's a bright star? Well, let me show you. First, you're gonna need a straight edge. And the different size of straight edges that you get, the better. Here's a sample of one. This is a smaller one. You can get bigger ones. You can make your own. You know, you can go to any hardware store, get something like this. All right. So I'm going to use the smaller one, and I'm going to use my white. Gloss white. Remember, it's important, guys. All right. I'm going to create a nice little bright star, maybe right about here. I'm just going to show you how we do this. You just remember, you never want to aim directly on your painting. You want to aim, well, I tell you what, let me see. This side is darker, so I'll show you exactly where to aim when doing this on your painting. I'm just going to put that right about there. Notice, it's right there. So you want to spray there and let the mist come down onto your painting. You'll be able to create some pretty sharp and defined lines that way. That way. Now you want all your points to intersect in the middle. So look at that. You have a nice little bright star there. All the points intersect correctly. This again may take a little bit of practice. I think I want to add another one right up here. All right. Okay, so now you have two bright stars, you have your sun right in the middle, you have this nice little nebula right there. I think this painting is the perfect example of what a basic beginner level spray painting should look like. Now, again, it does take a little bit of practice for you to get used to your paints, but let's take a look at what we've created. What do you say? Again, you just grab and remove. Look at that planet. It's the same here. Very easy to do, very fun. Look at that. All right, well, that is the basics of spray painting, guys. You've learned how to create depth by manipulating light, shadows, right here. You have your light bursts. You've learned how to create transitional colors so that they go into one bright source. And you learn how to create a nebula as well as stars. Easy to do, right, guys? Well, as you can tell, spray painting can be a lot of fun, very easy to learn, very quick to pick up. So if you want to learn more about the art of spray paint, please like, comment, subscribe to our channel, or you can visit our website, www.spraycasso.com, for more information. We still got plenty of techniques to learn. You've tackled on the basics. Are you ready for the intermediate? Visit us. Till next time, crew, keep those cans shaking.